12 Palisades High School. I wanted to take a moment to review the end of year schedule as the semester is quickly coming to a close. So a lot of this information has been communicated through my weekly email with detailed schedules and what's going on over the next couple weeks leading up to graduation for our seniors and the end of the school year for our underclassmen. So let's begin with our seniors. Seniors, please be reminded that tomorrow, Thursday, May 26th, we have the final round of portfolio presentations. If you are one of those seniors that still needs to present, please be sure that you know your time and location, and please remember that this is a part of the graduation requirement. Also on Thursday, May 26th, we will be giving out caps and gowns during period two. In addition, every cap and gown will have 6 tickets located in the envelopes. This is in a situation, if we have the ceremony on June 3rd and it gets postponed due to inclement weather, we'll come back on Saturday morning on June 4th. If for some reason the weather is not cooperating, we will move inside at that time. So once again, June 3rd, we're hoping to be outside. If we can't, we'll come back on Saturday morning, again, with the hope of being outside. Worst case scenario, that we have to move inside on June 4th, and then we are limited to 6 tickets per graduate. A reminder for our senior technical school students that the last day for you at the tech school is going to be Friday, May 27th. Continuing with our information and our summary for our senior students, please remember that Monday for all of our students, May 30th, is a holiday. Enjoy your day off. And on Tuesday, May 31st, our seniors begin exams. Exams will take place within the structure of the regular school day. Therefore, seniors do not need to be here for periods 1 and 2, but they will need to be here for periods 3 and 4 if they have an exam. Mrs. Schlosser sent information out about returning Chromebooks and other equipment. Please refer to that and the times for those materials to be returned on the 31st. Moving on to Wednesday, June 1st, exams will continue for our seniors while the underclassmen continue to have regular school. On the 1st, seniors will take their period 1 and 2 exams during periods 1 and 2. Period 3 and 4, seniors, you will not need to be here. Seniors, moving along with the rest of that week, graduation week as I like to think of it, Thursday, June 3rd is exam makeup day. You only need to be here if you have an exam to make up. On Friday, June 3rd, graduation day, graduation practice is required of all our seniors, and that will take place at 10 a.m. in the auditorium. A detailed exam schedule and end of year schedule is posted in the link, and it's also been sent out through my weekly email. Seniors, please remember exemptions do exist for you. It needs to be a 90% or better in your classes. If you're taking an AP class, it's an 85% or better, and you must have taken the AP exam. So please work with your teachers to identify whether or not you're somebody who is exempt from your final exams. And last but not least, for our seniors, please be sure to turn in all outstanding materials, turn in your Chromebooks, and pay for the materials that you've lost along the way. You need to clear your accounts prior to June 3rd so that you actually do receive your diploma following the ceremony. Now, moving on to our underclassmen and their end of year schedule. First, let's start off by talking about our technical school students. If you are an underclassman student and you go to the technical school, please note that Friday, June 3rd, is your last day to go to the technical school. On Monday, June 6th, we begin exams for our underclassmen students. So on Monday and Tuesday, we will give exams on that half day schedule that we used during the first semester. So again, let's jump back to Monday, June 6th, period 1 and 2 exams will be given, 7:45 for your period 1 exam and 9:20 for your period 2 exam. As we have done in the past, if you have your own transportation following your exam, you will be able to leave. If you need to stay through for the school district transportation at 2:27, we will provide lunch and then give you an opportunity to work in the library preparing for your next day exam. On Tuesday, June 7th, we will give the period 3 and period 4 exams. Period 3 will begin at 7:45 a.m., while your period 4 exam will begin at 9:20. on Wednesday, June 8th. This is the exam makeup day. So if you have any outstanding projects, outstanding exams, you will need to come to school on June 8th to take those. If you've turned everything in, if you've taken all your exams, you do not need to be here on Wednesday, June 8th. As a note, if you are here on Wednesday, it is an early dismissal for our students. Students, once again this year, our underclassmen students will be able to keep their Chromebooks throughout the summer. Please be sure to keep those in a safe place and bring those back to school in August of this next school year. Once again, please be sure to take your exams seriously as it counts for up to 20% of your final grade. Make sure that you've prepared adequately. And yes, all students must be here, unless of course you are exempt, and that's seniors only for the most part, to either complete an exam or a final project during the final weeks of the semester. So once again, all of this information is contained within my weekly emails. Please be sure to go there and look at the details scheduled. Let's have a strong finish. It's been a great school year. We've worked through a lot of challenges. And please take those exams seriously, as they really do count a lot for your final grades. Thank you.